Hello everyone. So good morning, good afternoon, good evening to you from the regions you are joining in. So thanks for the joining in our webinar on this very topical subject. So I am your host for the day. My name is Ruturaj Patil. I am a product manager for phytogenic liquids at a global animal nutrition company, EW Nutrition. So presently I am based in Germany. I have completed my master's in veterinary medicine and MBA in international business. So I have total 15 years of experience now in poultry and international animal health industry. So for today's webinar, with me, I have two panelists who will support me during this webinar with content and technical issues. So let me introduce them first. The first one is Ajay. Ajay, can you please introduce yourself?
Hi, I am Ajay Bhoyer. I am Global Technical Manager for EW Nutrition based in US. Very glad to have a healthy exchange with you. Thank you, Martin.
Yeah. Yes, yeah. Hi, everybody. We enjoy you to stay with us in this webinar. We hope this can be helpful for you. I'm Martin Roa from Mexico. I'm the technical representative in Mexico, and we hope you to enjoy this presentation. Hi.
Thanks. Thanks, Ajay. Thanks, Martin. So just few technical points to explain the setup of this webinar. I will deliver my presentation in about 40 minutes. During this presentation, you can ask questions in the Q&A form that opens when you click on the Q&A at the bottom of your screen. These questions are read and possibly answered in real time by the panelist. If they require a longer or more complex answers, we will save them for a Q&A session at the end of the presentation. So at the end of the presentation, we also kindly invite you to leave your feedback on this webinar. We will have a poll, and I will keep the poll open for 3 minutes after I close the session. So once again, thanks. Thanks for being here. And now let's start. So to begin with, I will explain you about the outline of today's webinar. So I will be first talking on the functioning of the respiratory system in the poultry. So we will look into how the respiratory system of birds are different than the mammals. Then we look into respiratory disorders and the impact on the bird's performance and the profitability. Then we'll see into the customer expectations. So as a farmer, what you expect when there is a respiratory problems in the farms. Then we'll look into some success stories for the solutions from EW Nutrition. And then last, we will look into our recommendation and conclusion. Yeah, so to begin with, let's see the respiratory system of the poultry. And as we see here, the respiratory system in the poultry is very complex and much different anatomically than the mammals. So lungs, yes, which are very small in poultry, they cannot expand because they are firmly attached to the ribs. They can't inflate or deflate. So air has to pass through the air sacs. So in mammal, the lungs function as a both ventilator as well as gas exchangers. But in the avian system, these functions are separated. The air sacs provide ventilation, and the lungs are known for, or they are known for the function for gas exchange. There are total 9 air sacs in the birds. So the distension and compression of these air sacs allows the airs moving in and out. So we can see the 9 air sacs, like one is unpaired, one at the cervical region. There are 2 interclavicular air sacs, then 2 abdominal air sacs, 2 anterior thoracic air sacs, and 2 posterior thoracic air sacs. So in poultry, the respiratory system is also called as non-tidal system. And this is because we know about tidal system, which is always linked with the lung volume, which represents the normal volume of air displaced between normal inhalation and exhalation when extra effort is not applied. But in case of birds, since the air sacs has been involved in the respiration, there is no specified volume for the lungs to do inhalation or exhalation. So in birds, the respiratory system is called as non-tidal system. And the separation of the functions between lungs and air sacs allows a continuous airflow through the lungs, as opposed to the tidal airflow in case of mammals. So for this reason, birds are able to extract higher percentage of oxygen from the air, which might be also requiring when they are flying at high altitude. So birds also don't have a diaphragm, so they cannot cough. So the movement of the lungs is depend on the movement of the sternum as well as rib cage, which is involved in the breathing. Now we'll look into important functions of the respiratory system. And as we all know about gas exchange, which is very, very common function of the respiratory system, one of the most important, which involve into exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide. But there are many other multiple important functions of avian respiratory system, which comes with release heat, or we also call as thermoregulation. Because at high temperature, bird cannot release the heat like mammals, because they don't have sweat glands. So at high temperature, birds increases their respiration rate to increase the amount of air passing through the respiratory system. And that will help into increasing cooling by evaporation. The panting also involves gular flutter in the birds, which the rapid movement of the upper throat tissue also increases evaporation. The movement of the air around the body of the bird will assist in removing heat from the bird as a sensible heat as well as insensible heat. The normal adult bird body temperature ranges from 41 to 41.7 degrees centigrade. But at the 46 degrees centigrade, bird can collapse and they die. So the second function comes from, or third function comes from the respiratory system is a detoxification. And it's also a very critical role because lungs are the first detoxification organ to come into contact with the airborne toxins, chemicals, viruses, bacteria, and many other foreign body irritants. We should also enhance the lungs' ability because it also supports in detoxifying capacity of the birds by simple process of even breathing. So the last, the most important also function comes with acid-base balance, which also involve into maintaining the pH of the blood. Because respiratory system contributes to the balance of acid and base by reducing the carbonic acid level. And the bird pH, blood pH is around 7.35 to 7.45, which is a very, very narrow range. And birds are very sensitive for any fluctuation between this range. Next, we will look into the respiration rate. And also it is very interesting to know about the respiration rate per minute in the birds also varies a lot. During the light period, the respiration rate is average 35 per minute. And during the dark period, the respiration rate would be around 23 per minute. But during the hot weather, the respiration rate can go up to 150 per minute, so which is very high. And just to compare, in adult human, we have a respiration rate between 12 to 20. So that shows how the bird's respiratory system works very fast and efficient during the heat stress to work as a thermoregulation. Now we look into a respiratory system. Normal defensive elements present. And we all know about cilia and goblet cells, which are present in the upper respiratory tract, especially in the trachea. Cilia are thin hair-like structures which are known for their characteristic sweeping movement. And goblet cells are mucus secreting cells. So they maintain the moisture and trap the particulate material or pathogens moving into the lumen of the birds or the upper respiratory tract. But the very important point to know is the goblet cell number is always variable, and the number can vary with physical or chemical irritation of the epithelium. So, and this is a kind of inflammatory response of the body. So whenever there is a respiratory problem, we can see always a extra mucus secretion. And this is because the goblet cell number goes high and they secrete more and more mucus. The consistency of the mucus is also very important for the efficient functioning of the cilia, because too thick mucus can collapse the cilia and the mucociliary apparatus can fail. So I have one small clip here which shows how the normal functioning of cilia and goblet cell works together. So you can see the cilia, which are working with the characteristic sweeping movement, and there is a simultaneous secretion of mucus. So they work in the sink, which is also called as a mucociliary apparatus, and they are efficiently able to take out the particulate or microorganisms which can able to enter into upper respiratory tract. There is also a third defensive element present in the respiratory system, which are scavenging cells. And these scavenging cells are nothing but phagocytic cells, which are present in the lower respiratory tract, which actively scavenges inhaled particles and bacteria, which can able to gain entry into lower respiratory tract. These cells consume the bacteria and kill them, thus preventing their functions and or prevent the spread of these bacteria in the respiratory tract. So during any infection or inflammation related with the respiratory problems, the mucociliary apparatus may be dysfunctional. So although this defensive element is very important, but it can get dysfunctioned during the respiratory infections because of narrowing of the airways, which mainly happen because of three major reactions patterns of the mucus. First can be hypersecretion of the mucus because of the increased goblet cell number. Then it also may be because of the high viscosity of the mucus, which is secreted during the inflammation. And there will be also a impaired mucociliary clearance because of the too thick mucus. Now we look into the factors which affects the respiratory system in the birds. So as we all know about airborne origin factors like ammonia and dust particle, which are very commonly present into any farm because of some managemental issues like dry litter conditions, overcrowding, feeder, poor ventilation, feeding. So all these can cause a lot of dusting and ammonia formation in the farm, and which can create adverse effect on the health because of the irritation in the bird's respiratory tract, and it can also cause the lowering of the resistance in the birds. Generally, because of this airborne dust particles can also cause tracheal plugs, which is nothing but a block at the junction of the bronchi, and can create a suffocation. And suffocation is the major reason of mortality during respiratory problems. So I would say the major mortality are happening in the respiratory problems are because of the suffocation and not because of the infection. And as the bigger birds need more oxygen, they are more susceptible for hypoxic conditions because of the suffocation. So whenever there is a respiratory problem in the birds, we will always lose the bigger birds. So you will never see the small birds or dark birds are dying because of suffocation or because of respiratory problems. And that creates the huge economical significance or profitability impact on the farms when they get affected with respiratory issues. Now we'll look into some pathogenic causes, and as we all know about, there are many pathogenic causes, etiological factors like viral origin and bacterial origin, Newcastle diseases, infectious bronchitis, infectious laryngotracheitis, pneumovirus, fowl pox, mycoplasma, infectious coryza. But the very important point to know about that it's very rare to have a pure infections in case of respiratory system, because it may always get complicated because of the multifactorial nature. And this happens because whenever there are primary pathogen infections like enlisted here in the top, there can be immunosuppressive agents also like Gumboro or IBD, chicken anemia virus, Marek's virus, and mycotoxins, which help or which can cause immunosuppression in the birds. And birds can become susceptible to the infections. There can be also aggravating factors like environmental or nutritional factors, which we shown in the previous slide. And this results into the complication of the respiratory pathogens with the secondary bacterial infections like E. coli and Pasteurella. So the importance of showing this slide is the any additive which can support symptomatically can help to control the secondary infection, because if you can support the immunity of the birds and which supports the symptoms of the birds during the respiratory challenge, we can avoid the birds to get into secondary complications. And that's why the symptomatic relief to the birds or any additive which supports symptomatically during respiratory diseases can help us to minimize the use of antibiotics by avoiding to get into secondary complications. Now we'll look into economical impact of the respiratory disorders. So, or we can also say the consequences of the respiratory diseases in birds. So to begin with, we all know about dyspnea and gasping, which is nothing but difficulty in breathing, which always start with whenever there is a respiratory problems. It also disturbs the thermoregulation, because we have seen the thermoregulation is also connected with the respiratory system's health. And the higher respiration rate can also cause dehydration because of the panting. Birds stop eating, and then it also has impact on the feed conversion ratio as well as on the production cost. It can also cause immunosuppression. So birds become more susceptible to catch up any secondary infection during this period. And because of the high density of the birds in any given farm, the respiratory infections are always accompanying with very high morbidity as well as mortality. So it can have huge impact on the performance of the birds. And generally the treatment cost in the respiratory problems is very high with poor prognosis. So what I mean by here is it would be very difficult to bring back the performance of the flock to the normal. So whenever you get hit of the respiratory problems, it would be very difficult to bring back the flock. So early intervention is very, very important for avoiding the economical losses during any respiratory disorders in the birds. So after seeing into this economical impact, now let's look what actually customer expect. So what as a poultry farmer, you may really look into when there is a respiratory problem. So to begin with, yes, as we talk about breathing relief, because of breathing relief is very important to relieve the birds from the pressure or the form the mucus, and which is very, very visible and easily identifiable by reduction in the sound. So we always know about respiratory rails or gurgling sound, which starts mainly because of the mucus. And as a customer, you expect to give immediate relief to the birds, maybe within span of 24 to 36 hours after starting the medication. Improvement in appetite. Yes, this is another second expectation from the customer point of view, because any medication given during this period is always through water or feed. And if birds are not coming on the water and feed, they are not able to get access to the medicine. So it is very important to bring back them on the feed for the medication as well as for supplying them energy, because if they have to recover, they need more energy. So improvement in appetite can help the birds to recover faster. Yeah. And then the third important expectation from the customer point of view is reduction in mortality due to respiratory infections. So customer expect to lose as less as birds due to respiratory infection in the flocks. So ultimately, what is the overall expectation from the customer point of view is quick recovery from the respiratory symptoms with or without antibiotic uses. And why I'm mentioning over here, because many of the infections in the poultry are viral origins and which are need not to be necessarily treated with antibiotics, because antibiotic can just support the secondary infections, but they are not actually treating the primary pathogens. So whenever there is a viral primary pathogen infections, only thing what we can do is to support the immunity of the birds, and we have to give symptomatic relief. And if you can do that successfully, we can even treat the birds with minimizing antibiotics use, because we can avoid them to get into secondary complications. So how it can be achieved? So we have a solution for that. Gripozone is our product from EW Nutrition. So Gripozone is a liquid product which supports the normal functioning of the respiratory system in challenging periods. Gripozone contains standardized amount of selected phytomolecules with strong mucolytic and immunomodulating properties. So Gripozone supports the respiratory health and also helps to mitigate the need of antibiotics and support the performance. And how it can be done? Because of this, Gripozone is bringing a strong mucolytic activity. It gives immediate relief to the birds from the symptoms by relieving them from the mucus. It naturally helps the birds to bring back on the feed and water, which improves their appetite. And Gripozone also supports the immunity by a good immunomodulating support from the phytomolecules, ingredients present in the Gripozone. And ultimately, it helps into overall better performance of the birds and improvement in the livability. So this is about the key mode of action of Gripozone. Now, we will look into some scientific proof how the ingredients in Gripozone are able to do that. So Gripozone contains volatile essential oils or phytomolecules like menthol and 1-HCineol. So these are very volatile natured phytomolecules. And because of their volatile nature, they have a natural ability to directly reach to the site of intended activity. Because of volatile nature, they are always available when the birds start inhalation, and they reach to the upper respiratory tract and start working as a mucolytic and bronchodilator. So menthol is known for bronchodilation, which is nothing but dilating the bronchi, the lower respiratory tract, and it also increases the responsiveness of the airways. So it helps into reducing the respiratory discomfort and sensations of dyspnea. 1-HCineol is also known for bronchodilation, and it also known to have a strong mucolytic activity, which is nothing but breaking down or dissolving the mucus, and it helps into facilitating easier removal of mucus and clearance of the mucociliary apparatus during these high challenge conditions. 1-HCineol also known for anti-inflammatory activity, which supports the pulmonary function. Now we look into some other scientific validations for the ingredients in Gripozone. And this reference talks about immunomodulation. So the phytomolecules present in Gripozone are known to promote both cell-mediated as well as antibody-mediated response. And it can be done by increasing immunoglobulin production, by increasing lymphocytic activity, and by increasing interferon gamma release. some references, which also talks about anti-stress activity of the ingredients in Gripozone and anti-inflammatory activity. So the phytomolecules in Gripozone are known to alleviate the stress during any stressful situations like vaccination. So as we all know about vaccination, which is an unavoidable stressor in the regular management practices of the birds, we have to do vaccination, but vaccination are also kind of stress to the birds. And if these are causing stress to the birds, we cannot expect a better immune response. So supporting the immunity during high stress situations like vaccination is very important. So the phytomolecules are known to enhance the efficacy of vaccination by promoting better antibody production. 1-HCineol also has anti-inflammatory, pain relieving, or edema reducing properties. And this is very, very important during high challenge conditions during the respiratory infections. So this is what we look into, the scientific proofs or references which are known about the ingredients in Gripozone. And now we look into some field validations. So some success stories around the world for Gripozone. To begin with, we'll talk about this study from Thailand. And in this study, we studied about effective mitigation of ILT vaccine reactions. And we as all know about ILT, infectious laryngotracheitis infection, especially in the layers, can has a huge impact on the productivity of the birds. And that's why we use live vaccines of ILT in the growing stage. So in this study, we have studied the vaccine reactions, elevation or mitigation by Gripozone supplementation. So we done in the two groups. One group was controlled with 10,000 birds and another group with Gripozone 10,000 birds, and Gripozone was supplemented at 200 ml per 1,000 liter of water post vaccination from third day to seventh day. So Gripozone was supplemented for 5 days from third day after the vaccination to the seventh day. Then each group of these were of 44 cages were randomly selected for careful observation, and the frequency of gurgling sound and the birds suffering from oculonasal lesions were measured on the day 5 to 7 post ILT vaccination. And because ILT live vaccines always known to cause a lot of severe vaccine reactions, so we just studied in this how Gripozone could support and what was the result. So results, bird receiving Gripozone showed 3 to 4 times less gurgling sound compared to the control group. And as you can see on the right side of the table, on day 5, day 6, and day 7, Gripozone supplemented birds, the vaccine reaction was gone down from 1 to 4 or 1 to 3. So what was the benefit? Gripozone was able to prevent the negative effects of the vaccination, which helps into stabilizing the feed consumption and supports the bird's immunity. So we can expect the better vaccine response as well as stabilizing feed consumption in the growing stage of the layer bird is very important, because anything which affects on the feed consumption can affect on the uniformity of the birds and also affect on the CV percentage, which can have impact during the laying stage of the birds. Next study coming from Turkey. And this is in the broilers. We did study in the Ross 308 commercial broilers. This is a field study in the farm with 120,000 birds capacity. So half number of birds, 60,000 birds, we kept as a control and 60,000 birds as Gripozone treatment group. And Gripozone was supplemented at 250 ml per 1,000 liter of water. And interestingly, this farmer has adapted it's his own application method based on the known benefits of Gripozone. So what he did, that he has supplemented Gripozone just for 24 hours water for a day during high stress days or like vaccination or feed change, which been commonly found in his regular farm managements. And he is used Griposone after each 5 days gap, starting from age day 10. So supplementation was done on day 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, and 35. And all birds were slaughtered on day 43. So what was the result? So you can see here, Griposone supplementation could support the average body weight as well as the mortality. There was a 0.3% improvement in the livability in the birds supplemented with Griposone, and 80 grams extra body weight in the birds of group supplemented with Griposone. Also, the feed conversion ratio, it was 3 points better in Griposone group and 21 points for EEF for Griposone. So all studied performance parameters shown better results in Griposone supplemented group. And this was mainly because Griposone supplementation could alleviate the stress, and it obviously supported the higher performance in broilers. The next field study, or I would say a customer feedbacks, we have from India, and these are known with effective control on respiratory signs. And in India, Griposone used by aerosol spray. And these are the wordings coming from our customer, that after observing high respiratory rates, Griposone was used, and the sounds reduced after aerosol spray in span of few hours. So this was possible mainly because of mucolytic activity coming from Griposone, which was able to reduce the sound because of the less mucus and the gurgling sound was going down. During the high incidence of respiratory sounds, we use aerosol spray twice on first day and repeat the spray once a day for next 3 days. So this customer is talking about Griposone use during the high challenge conditions when they are using Griposone first day as two times in a day, and then it was followed every day once for next 3 days. So as based on their experience, now they also started using Griposone as a prevention tool through drinking water for 3 days based on the occurrence of sounds from previous batches. And as we all know about a subcontinental hot humid climate in India, especially from the March to mid of June, we always get high respiratory problems in broilers. And so this farmer started using Griposone as a prevention based on his experience from previous seasons and also based on the symptoms observed in the adjacent farms. Because in some of the regions, when you have very high density of the birds because of more number of farms and the nearby farms already started respiratory signs, Griposone was able to prevent the infection start in those flocks. So Griposone what could able to use as a prevention tool in these farms. Next, customer feedback is coming from USA. And this farmer is talking about, yes, we have received our uses of Griposone in most of early respiratory cases in which we have rales, nasal discharges, slight lethargy, but not showing signs of bacterial pneumonia. And we use some good success on preventing the viral challenge from developing into bacterial pneumonia and reducing the need of antibiotics. So this farmer is exactly pointing about that there are some viral pneumonia cases in the birds, and early intervention of Griposone was able to support the bird's immunity as well as symptomatic relief to the birds, which helps them not to get into secondary complications. And that's why it could help into decreasing the need of antibiotics. So especially in USA, when there are no antibiotics ever kind of claims are being made, farmers are looking for reducing or even avoiding need of antibiotics in the farms, even case of respiratory change signs. And Griposone is able to help them to bring as a one tool. And this farmer is talking about Griposone was immediately increases water intake, which helps into speed recovery of flu. Yeah, because we always know that increasing water intake is kind of first sign of recovery. And if birds are starting coming on the water, obviously they start also eating feed, and that's why the energy uptake goes up and they start recovering very fast. So this was all about our field experience, our field trials. And now we look into some quality management points. Yes, obviously quality is our top priority, and products coming from Germany, we don't need to talk much on the quality parameters, because the all products being manufactured in GMP plus compliance facilities. But the special thing about EW Nutrition, all our products are being manufactured in our own premises. So right from the raw material sourcing to the finished good quality release, everything is being done by our own people. So we have end-to-end process control, which helps into each batch control on the each product manufactured by EW Nutrition. Then no batch-to-batch variation. Yeah, so especially for the phytomolecule-based products, it's very, very important, because based on the knowledge or the references available on the web, it's very easy to produce phytomolecule-based products. And you might be already seeing many phytomolecule-based products are already available in the market. But what is important or difficult in case of phytomolecule-based product is to ensure batch-to-batch consistency. And this can be only possible when you know which phytomolecule at what quantity is responsible for the required activity. And with strong R&D backup at EW Nutrition, we can ensure that our raw materials are standardized and we have a batch-to-batch same quantity of phytomolecules. So we can ensure that there will not be any up and down during the use of the products in terms of the efficacy of the products. All products are being also constantly monitored to detect undesired substances like dioxin, heavy metals, or other toxic compounds. And then Gripozone is also coming with excellent mixability, and which is very important for the application, especially in the poultry, because you are using the product in one overhead tank and it has to be distributed in within the thousands of birds. So the product which has good mixability can also ensure good bioavailability. So Gripozone is coming with excellent mixability, which supports into or which helps into each and every bird can get medicine or supplemented during the application. So coming to our recommendation for application through drinking water for broilers and for broiler breeders or layers. So we are recommending Gripozone application with two methods, one as a prevention. So prevention use is recommended at 100 ml per 1000 liter for 3 to 5 days, and which can be started after the vaccination when you are doing the vaccines like IB, ND, ILT. And the post-vaccine reactions being observed in the birds, we can start using Gripozone, which helps into supporting the immunity, getting better vaccine response. And Gripozone also can be used as a prevention during high stress situations like heat stress. So 100 ml per 1000 liter of Gripozone can support the birds during the high stress situations. And the second use comes as a therapeutic or reactive dose, which we recommend to use Gripozone at double dose, 200 ml per 1000 liter of water for 3 to 5 days based on the severity of infection. So because of the strong mucolytic and immunomodulating activity of Gripozone, it helps into faster relief of respiratory symptoms and help into contributing, reducing or minimizing the need of antibiotics in the farms. So Gripozone can be also used through aerial spray. Of course, it is based on the regulatory compliance, as we are noting here. Some of the countries, based on their regulatory compliance allowed, we are recommending to use Gripozone through aerial spray. And the method would be use 200 ml of Gripozone in 10 liters of water, that is 2% solution of Gripozone. And this 2% solution of 10 liter quantity can be spread on 200 square meter area for 2 to 3 days, twice daily. Generally, we recommend to use this spray in cool hours, early morning and late evening. When you are spraying, it can be always done directly on the spray on the birds, which helps into creating direct nebulization effect. And we also suggest to maybe little control the ventilation during the spray, which has a bigger impact of the particles or droplets of griposon solution would remain in the environment for a little longer and can create a real nebulization effect in the birds. So coming to the take home message, griposon is an effective tool for managing respiratory disease. So along with the excellent water mixability or being a liquid, which also offers a flexible on-farm application, griposon comes with three major mode of actions, which are like quick relief by mucolytic and relaxant activity. And this is very important to know that griposon is supporting symptomatically. So irrespective of the etiology, it might be viral problems or a bacterial problems in respiratory disease, griposon can work because griposon is not treating the infection, but it is treating the symptoms. So it gives a very quick relief to the birds by mucolytic and relaxant activity. It helps into enhancing water and feed intake, which is very important for birds to improve the performance, bring back them to gain more energy, which helps into speeding the recovery of the birds. And third, it supports the post-vaccination immune response. So it is very important to ensure the bird's immunity is at optimum level when we are doing vaccination. So griposon can help to maintain the immunity at the optimum level, and you can get a optimum vaccine response after the vaccination. So this was my last slide, and if you have any questions, we welcome you to put some questions in Q&A, and I can see already there are some questions in Q&A, and we'll look into it. Thank you.
Thank you, Ruturaj. I could see there are many questions that the participants have posted. And I would like to start with the first question that I thought that let me pick it. So how can griposon support birds in heat stress? So this is a very interesting question. And I would like to answer this question in two different points. First thing is that we know that during the heat stress, to cool down the body or to get relief from the heat stress, there is always, we can see that increase in the respiration rate. That's the way bird cool down itself. So imagine if the heat stress is complicated with the respiratory symptoms, then it becomes very difficult for the bird to have the respiration speed needed to cool down the body. So I think in that case, if you add griposon in your heat stress elevation strategy, it will help greatly to facilitate the respiratory rate that is needed. This is one thing. Now, the other aspect is, as Ruturaj was mentioning, the properties of the phytomolecules in the griposon, they also have the immunomodulating effect. That means it will help bird to maintain the immune status, which is generally compromised during the heat stress. So basically, it will facilitate the respiratory rates which is required by the bird to cool down the body. Maybe Martin, you may want to take another question.
Yes, there's another question that we can give an oral antibiotic along with Gripasone spray. Yes, of course, you can use even in the water with the spray. Gripasone is a support therapy. Even and sometimes you can use Gripasone, and sometimes the antibiotic cannot be possible. It's not necessary to use the antibiotic sometimes, but you can use together in the same therapy with Gripasone. Sorry.
Yeah. Thank you, Ajay. Thank you, Martin. So I may like to take one question here. And what is the best way of Gripasone uses? This is from Anonymous, yeah? But I don't know who has raised this question, but he's asking about what would be the best way of application, aerosol or water? So our recommendation to use aerosol only when there is a severe infections already in the flock. I would say maybe already 20-30% birds are off feeding. They are not coming on the feed and water. And during that conditions, we need to support birds immediately. Immediate intervention would be required. And that time spray can help better. Because of the spray, it also has direct impact on the upper respiratory tract, which works very effective as a mucolytic. And birds can get immediate relief from the mucus. And then they improve their appetite. So once they start coming on the feed and water, we can follow Gripasone application in the water. But coming to the regular uses as a prevention or early intervention in the respiratory cases, we always recommend to use Gripasone through water because water uses of this kind of additives has also extra benefit like immunomodulation, which supports the birds for the immunity and also has a cooling effect. So our recommendation would be to use Gripasone through water is the best option. But during the high challenge conditions, we can always start with aerial spray.
So something that to complement this answer is about the, we can use Gripasone in the field. Of course, it's not a recommendation. It is because it's a solution with volatile phyto molecules. So the effects is better in the water, than spray, but not in feed. Just to complement the recommendation.
Thank you. Thank you, Martin. There is one question from Rodolfo Marin, and he's asking about what is the criteria to stabilize or establish a Gripasone control program at 1 day on a gap of 5 days from 10 days age. So Rodolfo, as I was mentioning about, this was a field study we did with one of our customer in Turkey. And this was maybe a kind of a program or application being developed by himself. That was not our standard recommendation. That was maybe he observed or he thought to have this kind of application based on the challenges what he had in his farms, in the broiler, based on the, of course, even seasonal impact. This was done in the summertime there. And so our recommendation is always based on prevention, 3 to 5 days as 100 ml and as a reactive 200 ml per 1000 liter of water 3 to 5 days. But the very interesting thing from this farm trial, what we got it, that even this kind of intermediate or application of Gripasone was able to support on performance parameters. So we are not promoting Gripasone as a performance booster, but Gripasone is coming with a strong anti-stress activity and which can be always proven through a better performance of the birds. And that's what we thought to share this report in our presentation.
Puturaj, I will take the next question, which is related to next couple of questions, I would say. First is, can Gripasone reduce the mortality due to ascites in broiler? So my answer here will be, no, because ascites is a different metabolic disorder and the reason for mortality is not related directly to the respiratory distress, and Gripasone especially particularly aid in relieving the respiratory distress. Second question is, do your product complement thymulin or tilmicosin application during first 18 weeks of broiler breeder? So this question is from Dr. Rakesh Nimbalkar. And Dr. Rakesh, there are no known contraindications of briprozone since it's a phytomolecule-based product. And the answer, straight answer to your question is yes, briprozone will complement the thymulin or tilmicosin treatment to relieve the for the faster relief of the respiratory symptoms. Over.
Thanks.
Just to complement this, about the antibacterial activity of Gripozone, it renders a small activity of antibacterial of this product. It is not the focus of this product. This is not, you cannot use as an antibacterial medication. But it can be together, as Jay mentioned, that it can be together with another antibiotic or another alternative of medication. But it is not, the use of antibiotic.
Thanks, Martin and Ajay. I will take one question about how long are the volatile actives in Gripozone are stable after being added in the water for drinking? So this is something, yes, very important because the volatile oils in the Gripozone are been known to have benefits. So it also need to be ensured that how stable they are in the water. And this is, we can say, as we commonly know about the volatile oils are only get start acting when they are get exposed to the air. So when we are using Gripozone in the water line, they are always been coming to the bird level through the pipeline or to the nipple lines. So they are not actually started acting when they are already been not exposed to the air. So they can start only working when they are exposed to the air at the bird level. So once birds start drinking, the Gripozone added water, and then we can see the volatile oils are being started working. And this can be also easily identified even from few meters when Gripozone was being applied in the farm. You can smell Gripozone from maybe from few meters away from the farm already. And that shows that the strong volatile content of the Gripozone. And there was also one question about Gripozone is whether it's having antibacterial activity. So of course there are some references available about 1-8-cineol and menthol for antibacterial activity. They comes with a secondary benefit, but we don't recommend or our recommendation is not based on antibacterial activity of Gripozone. So what we are saying here is that Gripozone can complement the conventional therapies, which helps to minimizing the use of antibiotics, because antibiotics are only required when the infections are based on bacteria. If there is a viral infection, you don't need to even have antibiotics because they are not treating the infection. And so in those cases, Gripozone kind of product can be well complemented by strong immunity support and symptomatic relief to the birds. And I had also experience from some of the Middle East farms when there was a non-infectious respiratory challenges. This was especially in the environment control houses. And when the farms started the fans, and all of a sudden a lot of dust start coming. And that dust create a irritation to the birds in the upper respiratory tract, and birds also start producing the sound, which always get confused with respiratory issues, but those are not infectious problems. And those kind of respiratory issues, Gripozone can be the best solution because you are able to treat the symptoms of the birds by the mucolytic activity of Gripozone. There is one question from Dr. Bishu Harish Sharma, that at which level of relative humidity in open house Gripozone can good result of aerosol spray. And should we use lukewarm water? Good question, Dr. Vishu. But what I would say here, you don't need to have do something with the water temperature because gripozone is perfect miscible in the water. It creates a wholesome or uniform solution when it mixed with the water. So generally the water temperature has been increased to improve the solubility of any additives. And in case of gripozone, you don't need to do that. Gripozone itself is a very, very good water mixable. So a normal room temperature water is good enough for spray. And especially for the humidity, we don't need to be much considering about the humidity because the spraying itself is going to create impact on the humidity. You are automatically also increasing the humidity in the houses. So just simple spray with gripozone solution can help in high respiratory challenges. Yeah, so maybe I see some of the questions still there, but just to respect the time, we need to stop here. And you also can see the email ID, what is already displayed on the screen. We would welcome you to write your questions on this email, and this will come directly to us, and we will be happy to answer those questions. So as I mentioned at the beginning of my presentation, we would be having a small poll, which would be help us to understand about your feedback and opinion on this. So I'm just launching a poll and we would welcome your feedback on that. So thanks for joining. Have a nice day.
Thank you, Dr. Ruturaj.
Thank you, everybody, for joining us.